my brothers and sisters, this is your brother Santosh coming to you with yet another episode on the Blessed Life in Christ video and podcast series. Dear beloved, over the past several weeks and months now, we have been continuously meditating on prosperity, healing and faith, and recently we started a new main series called Back to the Basics. And today, dear beloved, we are going to meditate on prosperity, on blessing. And especially the series, we have named it as Let the Blessing Do Its Work. Let It Do Its Work. Let what do its work? It is the blessing. Let me read the key words for this series. It is Proverbs 10 and 22. It says, the blessing of the Lord makes one rich and he adds no sorrow to it. Dear beloved, in the past several days we meditated several things. It says, number one, blessing of the Lord does not involve any sorrow. Number two, it does not involve any sweat at all. And not only that, we also learned that the blessing of the Lord, it gives you anointing, it gives you knowledge, it gives you great strategies and tactics so that you can do things well. Dear beloved, today I'm going to share another topic about this blessing of the Lord. And I have named it, given the topic's name as Blessing of the Lord and Potiphar's Wife. Dear beloved, is there any relationship between Potiphar's wife and blessing of the Lord? Yes, indeed. Yes, there is a relationship. Then, for that, let us go to Genesis 39th chapter, and let me read it from the first verse. Okay. Now Joseph had been taken down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, bought him from the Ishmaelites who had taken him down there. The Lord was with Joseph, and he was a successful man, and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. Verse number 3. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made all he did to prosper in his hand. So Joseph found favor in his sight and served him. Then he made him overseer of his house, and all that he had put, he put under his authority. So it was from the time that he had made him overseer of his house, and all that he had, that the Lord blessed the Egyptian's house for Joseph's sake. And here is the cleanser. And the blessing of the Lord was on all that he had in the house and in the field. Then beloved, let us read the sixth verse. Thus he left all that he had in Joseph's hand, and when he did not know what he had except for the bread which he ate. Now Joseph was handsome in form and appearance. And it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast longing eyes on Joseph, and she said, lie with me. But he refused and said to his master's wife, look, my master does not know what is with me in the house, and he has committed all that he has in my hand. There is no one greater in this house than I, nor has he kept back anything from me but you, because you are his wife. How then can I do this great wickedness and sin against God? Dear beloved, here we see an interaction which happened between Joseph and Potiphar's wife. Dear beloved, when the blessing of the Lord is upon you, God blesses you. He not only just blesses you, but He also blesses the institution or the company or the place or the school, wherever it is. God blesses the institution, the place you are working for your sake. And that is exactly what happened. And that is exactly what happened in Joseph's case also. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and the Lord made all he did to prosper his hand. Because the blessing of the Lord is upon you, and as we saw, blessing of the Lord is an anointing also. When that anointing is upon you, others can identify it in your life. And not only that others identify it, but also that your work, whatever you do, it becomes a blessing. It becomes a blessing for others. It becomes a blessing for your master. It becomes a blessing for your owner. Dear beloved, that is what happened to Joseph here. Because of the, and the verse very clearly says, and the blessing of the Lord was on all that he had in the house and in the field. Blessing of the Lord. The blessing of the Lord does not bring, does not add any sorrow or any sweat to it, but it is because of this blessing, because of the blessing of the Lord in favor of Joseph, he is facing a trial here. Potiphar's wife, you know, because Joseph was handsome, you know, she had a longing eye on Joseph. And she was pestering him to sin with her. Dearly beloved, that is when you should realize, just as Joseph realized. Dear beloved, let me tell you something. If there is a plan of God in your life, take it from me, you are a target for the devil. The devil will try to do everything in his power to make you fall from the blessing of the Lord. If it happens, it will be a very big loss for the kingdom of God, because the purposes of God in your life will not be fulfilled if you sin. You know, just think what would have happened if Joseph sinned with that lady. You know, the very purpose of God preserving Joseph would have gone wrong. But, dear beloved, that did not happen. Why? Because of the blessing of the Lord. Because the blessing of the Lord is upon you, He will guide you. He will protect you. He will make you run away from those kind of situations and circumstances. Dear beloved, that is how God leads a person who is enjoying the blessing of the Lord. Many people confuse blessing with sin. Unfortunately, the churches also taught it like that. No, it does not. So, the blessing of the Lord, you know, when he realized, when Joseph realized that the blessing of the Lord is very, very important for his life, you know, he was able to run away from that lady instead of, you know, conniving with her. Dear beloved, that blessing of the Lord will ultimately take you wherever you are supposed to be. And as far as Joseph is concerned, he is supposed to be the number one person in Egypt. That is God's plan. And that is why the blessing of the Lord was upon Joseph. And that is why God was able to preserve Israel and his family, you know, from a drought which could have killed them. And that is how, you know, God protected and, you know, he prospered his will. Then, beloved, if you are a child of God, you have a plan of God also. And the devil will try to distort it, destroy it in your life. But because the blessing of the Lord is with you, because the blessing of the Lord is upon you, you will be able to overcome those challenges. May God bless you. We will meet in the next main series. And dear beloved, if you are blessed in any way with this broadcast, please share it with others. Please click the like button. Please click the subscribe button if you are looking at it in YouTube. And you just pass it on, because you are receiving it freely and you can freely give it away, and God will bless you for that. Praise the Lord, and I will see you in the next episode.